watching the first test flight for the Ryerson solar airplane.
It was fantastic. There was not a single glitch. We were able to fly for over two hours.
For this flight, flying electrically and not yet equipped with its solar panels, aerospace students at Ryerson are hoping that this plane will set the world record for unmanned flight and be able to fly 60 to 90 days nonstop.
If we could find a location that has favorable weather, we can push multiple weeks, maybe even multiple months.
So in here, this is the main autopilot system, and that's connected to different sensors. So here we have a GPS and our backup GPS, and then we have things like this unit here measures the power consumption of the vehicle, so we can kind of monitor that from the ground.
Tell me why this is exciting to be working on.
It's nice to try to push the boundary a bit, I think. That was why we started it, and it's getting exciting seeing that sort of come together.
To see it flying yesterday, what was that like?
It was exciting. It was nerve-wracking at the start.
They've been working on the design for about a year and a half.
I don't see it being to the scale of commercial aircraft just yet, but sort of having a technology demonstrator that shows it is possible for an aircraft of this size to be powered under solar power is a good step for aerospace design in general. And the more we can go towards electric aviation, I think the better it'll be.
Now that they know it can fly, they will spend the months ahead working on the solar power panels to ensure that this plane will be able to fly for 2 to 3 months at a time without landing. The team members envision several future application possibilities.
What we're looking at right now is using it to detect and monitor wildfires. So if we can catch wildfires earlier on, that can help us sort of manage them. There are environmental things we can look at, like coastal ice melting with thermal imaging, tracking wildlife populations.
Unmanned aircraft have developed over the last couple of years and the range of applications that they have to be able to think that, oh, we could possibly commercialize this into something that could be used, that people could take advantage of and not just be a plane that set the world record.
And of course, now that they've had their first successful test flight, there is still months of work ahead. It will be next May before this craft will fly again with the solar panels. At Downsview Park, Audra Brown, City News.